Hi! With Bitwig Studio's CV devices, you can easily send control voltage, gate and clock signals to and from your Eurorack modules and other CV-enabled hardware. In this video, I will show you how to incorporate your CV gear with Bitwig Studio and add a wide range of functionality to your modular setup. I will mostly focus on Eurorack gear, but everything I show you will work with any instrument or effect that can send or receive CV signals. Let's dive in. There are various ways to connect your modular gear to Bitwig Studio. You can use a dedicated CV interface or an audio interface with DC coupled outputs. Non-DC coupled interfaces can send out clock and gate signals as well, but might introduce some issues when it comes to CV voltages. When you connect your modular gear to an audio interface, make sure to use a mono adapter. You can recognize it by the two sections divided by one line. Before you connect your hardware, turn down the volume level of your speakers and headphones as a safety precaution. Be aware that Eurorack delivers much higher audio levels than regular studio gear, so be careful when you raise the volume once you connected everything. The hardware CV instrument is a device designed to play, control and record Eurorack voices or synths with Bitwig Studio. It's the perfect starting point for your modular adventures. Let's use it to control zero cost. Start by adding the hardware CV instrument device to an empty instrument track. As you can see, it can send out pitch and gate. I set pitch to channel 3 and gate to channel 4. Now I connect channel 3 of the audio interface to the pitch CV input of zero cost and channel 4 to the gate input. And finally, I connect the line output of zero cost to audio input 1 of my audio interface and set audio in to channel 1. Now when I press a note, the hardware CV instrument device sends gate and pitch to no cost and receives the audio back, all in one device. To automatically tune the oscillator, press tune. Bitwig will then play notes from low to high and calibrate the oscillator accordingly. You can also tune the oscillator manually and set the range and key tune voltages to your liking. You can detune the oscillator with the pitch offset knob and dial in the amount of glide. Once you've set up the hardware CV instrument, you can save it as a preset and load it to other tracks or projects later. Now you're ready to go. Play your modular voice with external MIDI controllers. Or from note clips that you record or draw in piano roll. Add modulators like beat LFO to modulate the pitch CV. Note effects devices like arpeggiator. And audio effects. With the hardware clock out device, you can send clock signals to your modular gear. Add it to the CV out devices of the hardware CV instrument or drop it on any instrument or audio track. If you take a look at the device, you'll notice it has two channels. Clock sends out a clock signal, which tells your external module at which speed your track is running. Connect one output of the audio interface to the clock input of your module or hardware synth and select that channel as clock output. The other channel is called reset. It tells the connected module when to start or restart the cycle, so it does not only run at the same tempo as your project, but in sync. If your module has a reset input, connect a second output of your audio interface to it and select the output channel accordingly. Now when you press play, the module runs in sync with Bitwig. The hardware clock out device can be adjusted for many different scenarios and needs. You can choose between different sync modes from the drop-down menu at the top. You can switch from a clock to a gate signal in case your module requires it. Set the reset value, change the time divisions, adjust the pulse length, and manually trigger the clock. If you place the hardware clock out device inside a hardware CV instrument, you can automatically adjust the latency compensation for the whole chain with Bitwig's click button. To adjust the latency manually, double-click and enter a value at the bottom of the device, or click and drag to change the setting. With the hardware CV out device, you can control, modulate, and automate any addressable parameter in your modular system with CV. Just like hardware clock out, you can add it to the CV devices or drop it on any audio or instrument track. For this example, I'm using a step sequencer to play the XPO oscillator module and then run it through the Q-pass filter. And now I want to modulate the cutoff and resonance of Q-pass from Bitwig Studio. Because two of my audio outputs are already occupied to control XPO and I need two more to modulate the filter, I switched from Audio 6 to Expert Sleeper's ES8, which gives me 8 DC coupled audio outputs. To modulate the filter cutoff, add hardware CV out to the CV out device section, select a free channel, then connect it to the filter input of the module. Now you can control the filter cutoff with the knob in CV out. Automate it from a MIDI clip or use modulators like LFOs. To control the resonance, just add a second hardware CV out device and assign it to another channel. You can add as many CV out devices as your interface supports and combine them with modulators to create unique complex patches that you can save as presets for other projects. CV from your modules can also be used to control devices in Bitwig Studio. To control a parameter from an external CV source, add the hardware CV in modulator to a device like Polysynth. Connect the CV output of your module to an input of your interface. Click on the modulator to open its settings and select the input you just connected your module to. To assign the CV input to a parameter of the device, click the mapping icon. Route the modulation and set the modulation depth by clicking and dragging on a control, like the filter cutoff frequency. Now Maths controls the filter of Polysynth. You can adjust the gain and smoothing of the incoming signal if necessary. This concludes our introduction to CV with Bitwig Studio. We hope this guide helps you get started and inspires you to explore, experiment, and have fun making music. If you enjoyed this video, consider subscribing to the channel for more tutorials and content about Bitwig Studio. Thanks for watching and see you soon!